The opposite is happening after traders in Iganga Central Market vowed not to take on the presidential directive to sleep in the market in a bid to restrict or rather halt the spread of the virus. The traders in the market say it is in a poor state and that staying in there will of course expose them rather to the disease that government is trying to ensure that they do not catch. They now want the government to construct a modern market for them.
Traders operating in Iganga Central Market are still commuting despite a recent directive that market vendors sleep in markets during the 42 days lockdown. According to the traders, the market is in a sorry state with rubbish and also leaking. The chairperson of the market says they cannot force traders to sleep in the markets despite it being a presidential directive.
When you look at the situation of the market, you also become sympathetic because, you know, someone may be fighting COVID, but in the long run or in the short run, you may find someone lose life because of the state of the market.
He also stressed the need for a modern market like other districts have. The Iganga municipality mayor agrees with the traders.
We appeal to the government to come and give us a modern market. Because this one, which is in existence, it is no longer a market. It is like a kiral. It is in a bad state. And I'm engaging the RDC to allow these people to be commuting from home, because there are those who commute from within.
We are trying to work together with government to see that even Iganga gets a new market.
Iganga Central Market was set up in early 1960s and accommodates over 1,000 traders. But over the years, it is dilapidated. Story by Ivan Wachibi for the news in Iganga District.
The market is very, very, very bad because our customers, they are running away because of these commandments.